I want to say a personal thank you to Shiloh Fire Department for putting my forest out.
Hey folks, it's Josh, Stoney Ridge Farmer. Welcome to the farm vlog today. Me and Mrs. Stoney Ridge, we've got a little bit of work to get done here. We've got a big rainstorm coming in, so we've got to light up two more burn piles, and this will be the last two gigantic burn piles on the farm for this season. We're gonna go over, we'll show you what we do to light these huge burn piles, and I'm talking about a burn pile that covers probably a half an acre, a huge burn pile, probably bigger than your house. So we wanna light that in low wind conditions, and we wanna light it right before it rains. That way, if any drifting embers were to run over on the neighbor's property, they'd be put out by the rainstorm. So we've got some pretty good storms coming in. We're gonna go have some fun today. So we're just about to the very last loads of rocks and sticks out on our land that we just cleared. So come along today and we'll show you what we're doing. All right, woo!
Stoney Ridge. Farm Stoney Ridge.
So guys, if you look out through here, there are the dogs, Lexi and Buddy. If you look out through here right now, this is the land that we just cleared off, and we've been picking up rocks and stones and sticks for days and days and days. It pretty much looked like the surface of the moon, but it's turning out pretty nice now. I'm pretty happy with it. So we left a few trees out here. This is a hickory tree, and we left that for the squirrels so they'll have nuts. And then we left some pretty maples, and these guys will flourish and they'll bloom out and get bigger and bushier as time goes on. And then if you look over here, we left several oak trees, and those are white oaks, and those drop a lot of acorns, and that's good for the deer. So we left some trees that'll be beautiful and good for the wildlife and good for our cattle. Once we have them, they'll have some shady spots.
Guys, Mrs. Stoney Ridge is deathly afraid of the electric goat fence. So we have a cool little system to get over the fence. She's like, I'm not scared of it. I'm just not stupid. I'm not gonna get into it. So what we do is we take one chair over here and put it on one side, and we take another chair, of course a metal chair, and put it on the other side. So then Mrs. Stoney Ridge, go ahead, demonstrate for us. There, that way she can step over the fence and hopefully not fall down, and then we won't have to go to the hospital. So guys, we just opened this area up right here for the goats. I didn't do a vlog on it just because it was so high stress to open this up for the goats, and keeping them under control was more important than making a video. But if you look, you can see our electric goat and sheep netting kind of goes around this whole little area, and it's probably encompassing about a quarter acre. And we'll go ahead and we'll move the goats as soon as they eat this down and put some good butt fertilizer down for us. Just some fun stuff, just what's going on here on the farm. And it's windy. I don't know if you guys can tell, but the storms are coming in. It's windy. Now guys, we're slowly becoming a working farm here, and we talked about this manure pile probably, I don't know, a month or two ago we turned the manure pile. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll return this manure pile, and we're gonna fill up the manure spreader over here and hit some spots in our new pasture areas that need a little more nutrient. What happened was the dozer basically pushed off all the topsoil and caused a not so nutrient rich area. So we'll take care of that. Probably sometime next week, if things dry up a little bit here on the farm, and that way we don't mire up in the mud. We'll hook the tractor to that thing and pull it around and spread some manure.
I think our feeder might be a little bit too tall for these little goats. Here comes some more. This really makes you appreciate living on a farm, guys. It's really fun.
Okay guys, so we've got little piles like this. Now you would call this a big pile in most people's worlds, but that's a fairly little pile compared to all the stuff that's burning over here now. And this is the new land that we were having cleared, and the guys are off. Today is Sunday. Right over there is one pile. You really can't tell the scale of it, but that pile right there probably is about the size of that goat pen area I just showed you. So a pretty large pile, and there's even bigger piles burning back there in the back. Now we can see this from the house, and it looks a whole lot smoother than it really is. So we'll show you here how bumpy it is, and all this stuff we've got to get up, all these sticks and roots and rocks and stuff, we're gonna have to get them up, and we're gonna have to smooth this out just a little bit more over the next few days, and we'll get some grass seed on it. And hopefully the grass seed will take, and we won't have a very dry summer this year. And then we'll have pasture. All of it will look like this. It's gonna be beautiful. This might be a little bit of a long vlog today, guys. I got a lot of stuff I wanna show you. Right here is where we had a burn pile in the past, and basically he just raked it all off and pushed it right down the hill into that burn pile. Pretty cool. You can see his tracks and where it kind of damaged the field a little bit, but it'll come back. Now as we look out here, you can really see the huge piles burning, and one of the piles we got to light up is right here in between all these piles, and the wind is blowing just right, blowing it away from the woods, so it's time to light it up. Okay folks, so we're right here at this burn pile, and this burn pile is probably about the size of a 1200 square foot two bedroom house. Okay, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna use approved fuel sources that are approved by the Forestry Service. This is diesel fuel and this is old diesel fuel, and what we're gonna do is toss this up on the fire and we'll light it with a little bit of lighter starter fluid and just let it burn. Now we're on the back side where the wind is blowing, so the wind is actually coming over this way, okay? It's actually blowing toward me and the fire is right here, so we'll receive less wind and it will start up slower if we put it on the back side of the fire, if we start it on the back side. So let's get busy. Check out this cool vintage old gas can. So we use this for starting the fires on the farm. This is our old gas can. It might have a little rust in it, so we don't use it for the tractor, but it's got diesel in it. Now guys, with a pile like this, this old pine stuff, it doesn't take much to get it going, and with the wind going like it is, it'll light up and go. So let's get it lit. Boy, this bucket of diesel fuel was really, really old and black. Now, as you can see, just the tiniest flame here is really gonna take this thing and roll. Here in about, 5 minutes or so, this thing will be a raging fire. If you guys like fire, this is a good vlog for you. So guys, what we wanted was this to catch up really slow. We didn't really want it to take off like boom. Now for film's sake, we wanted to show you it go woof, take off. But it's not taking off like we want it to. For you, it's taking off like we want it to for us. So this will slowly burn, and basically as the wind comes over, it'll create a little bit of a vacuum, I guess, a vortex, and suck hot flaming air into the pile here and let it burn up. We don't want it to burn too fast because we don't want a huge flame with giant embers flying all over and catching the forest on fire. The wind picked up and it's really, really blowing a lot of debris and embers out into the woods. So we're just having to babysit. We have 9 fires going right now. Huge, huge fires. And with this wind and the dry weather we've had, we're just praying for rain right now. If it rains an eighth of an inch, it'll stop anything in the woods from catching on fire. That's the biggest drama with this, okay? And the fire that we lit, the first one we lit, is the one you see smoking the most right back over there. It's doing pretty good, taking off like it should. We have one more fire that we're gonna light, and it's a huge, huge fire. It's the biggest fire that we have. Now, I don't know if I've told you guys in the past, what we have to do is we have to fill out a North Carolina Forest Service fire burning permit, and we have to call the sheriff's office and let them know that we're burning. Now, most every time we burn, even though we call the sheriff's office, we start hearing sirens, and here comes the fire department. It's kind of disappointing we're wasting tax dollars like that, but I guess it's better safe than sorry. So we got to babysit, a lot of babysitting. Guys, we're going to say bye-bye, and I appreciate you. Maybe here at the end of the video, after the credits, we might show you lighting the great big fire if it's not raining too hard. I imagine what's going to happen is a storm's going to come in. I'm going to be out here just getting covered in mud and soot and lighting up some fires. And they will burn, even though it's raining. All right, thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you next time on Stoney Ridge Farmer. Bad, bad, bad situation. Forest Service is here. Bad. Well, folks, we set the woods on fire. Back in here. A little bit drifted from way over here across the way, and the biggest fear actually happened. Got the fire department here taking care of business. Gotta go shake these guys' hands. A little bit shaky, camera's a little shaky, I'm a little nervous. Whew. There it is. There's your lesson. It gets windy when you start a fire.
I want to say a personal thank you to Shiloh Fire Department for putting my forest out. Thank you, buddy.
Is that loud enough, my love?
No.
Louder!
Speak up. Test.
Test. Test. Test.